If things are on my mind or I'm having problems, I put my board down and I ride for 20 minutes and I'm so focused on the tricks that I'm trying and so focused on what I'm doing that everything else disappears.
Once upon a time, I was of the mind to lay your burden down and leave you where you stood. You believed I could, you'd seen it done before. I could read your thoughts and tell you what you saw and never say a word.
I first just saw some local kids riding their boards around and I was absolutely mesmerized by it. Thought that it was the coolest thing I ever seen and that I had to try. And I got on and it was super hard, but I was so into it that I just got into it, started practicing. I'd say for the good first 10 years, I was skateboarding 7 days a week, several hours a day, sometimes 10 hours a day on the weekends or after school. At the time, skateboarding was kind of dead. It wasn't really popular. It was kind of one of the low points in skateboarding. So it really wasn't a popular age for anybody to be getting into it. But just for me, it was the beginning of high school. I had some high school friends that wanted to start skateboarding as well, so we got together and started skating. 1998, I started a group called Team EY, which was just a bunch of the local talented skateboarders and their supporters and local artists and just friends of our skateboarding crew. And Team EY was essentially just a way of keeping our skateboarding community together because it was so small at the time. If you were a little kid who just started, we were just as good as friends with you as the old guy who's been skating for a long time or the new young kid who's coming up. So it was not so much about talent, it's more about like keeping the community together and like representing skateboarding in a positive light. When I was maybe 18, 19 years old, I started traveling to Boston every summer to visit my family there and to California to visit my family there. And I started realizing how exciting it was to skate new cities and new places. So I basically spread the word amongst my friends to start skateboarding and traveling across the world. And some of the places we traveled to were Japan, Korea, we went to Dubai, we went to Morocco, we went to Spain, France, Germany. Been to England, all over the US, the East Coast and the West Coast, all the way across Canada. I'd say Barcelona in Spain is the best place I've ever skateboarded in my life. Best skateboarding spots, the marble plazas everywhere, it's just designed almost by a skateboarder, but it's not. But when you go there, you'd think it would be.
Blood slide.
Well, for me, my worst injury was probably on one of my trips to Japan.
This is what I love, this is what I do.
There's a real sense of ownership and pride in the skateboard park. Skateboarding has had a negative reputation in the past, and I think this is mostly due to the fact of undereducation about the sport and the fact that it's a new and it's a young sport. It's not heavily televised. You know, most people didn't grow up with it, so they don't know what it is. So to them, it's like, oh, the teenagers are doing this, young kids are doing this. I don't know what this is. I don't know what it is. It scares a lot of people. Skateboarders, I think, actually are an advantage that they have something that they're so passionate about that it focuses them and keeps them away from a lot of trouble. I think I've seen a lot of kids being saved by skateboarding. I think myself has been saved by skateboarding. It's so individual and creative. It's almost an art as well as a sport.
It was 9 years ago, me and a couple buddies were skating over at the Civic Center, and we got kicked out, and after getting kicked out, a local counselor approached us and says, hey guys, you should get organized, get a skate park in your community. It didn't work out, but with time and hard work, the skate park came to be a reality. And for me, it's like a dream come true. This is my home now. This is what I love. This is what I do.
3, 2, 1.
We didn't want to be selfish. The design elements in the park range from very beginner to very advanced. So it's actually for the whole community, for all the kids. There's stuff there that is directly meant for 5 and 6 year olds just for learning how to do basic riding. Then there's stuff there that I won't even touch. It's for kids that come from out of town that are really amazing, because the park's gonna have some sort of attraction to an outside community as well. So it really serves not only myself and Team EY, but it serves a much greater community, and more than just Toronto even. Well, for me, my worst injury was probably on one of my trips to Japan.
This is a slumper.
And we were there on an 18-day trip, and on the 10th day, I broke my leg in Japan. And that was the worst injury for two reasons. One, because I broke my leg, and the other one is because it sticks in my mind, because it ruined the last 8 days of my trip. I had to go and travel around all these amazing places to skateboard in Tokyo and across Japan, and all my friends were skateboarding, and I just had to watch or film. I spent more time behind the camera than in front of the camera. Still had a good time, but sticks out as the worst injury. With Team EY and all the skateboarding we've been doing, I've been one of the main filmers. I also do all the editing of our videos. We have 14 full-length videos that have come out in the last 18 years, as well as over 100 shorts. Some of the shorts are just small little road trips or just a local profile on a certain person. But our full-length videos are usually around half an hour long. We've shown them in many theaters. So what drives me to keep skating is that I'm always off to somewhere new to find new and interesting skate spots, spots that you can never find here in Canada, and places where people don't know about skateboarding and they don't care that you skateboard, so you don't get kicked out, you don't get hassled, you can ride in the streets, you can ride in the downtown plazas, and nobody cares. All right, in skateboarding, there's a really difficult trick called a backside nose blunt slide, and finally, after 18 years of skateboarding, I feel like I finally learned it this year.
About 900? No, on the list.
Not going to be doing any 900s. I know what it is. Killer Cali hustler, hit it by all means. The people know whatever they skate, need. You they idiots, ride your fucking skateboard, you loafers. Moving and we muscling. Grab an Evie and sit down. With the pigs like a Muslim. For the green we rushing. No, not Moscow. I'm talking quick, fast, in a hurry right now. Can't be a victim. Can't fall short. I just want to be a baller with my own ball.